his welcome from his panto dressing room, the king of the ballroom, Anton Du Beke. Shall we bow down to royalty? Do we bow down to royalty, Anton?
Please, please.
I am so excited to finally be able to chat with you on the show, but I need to ask you straight away, what did you make of Saturday night's show? Because there were some amazing highs and a couple lows.
Well, I thought it was a terrific show. I mean, we all love the bits that go wrong. those bits we always enjoy. It was quite daring. There were some real daring bits on Saturday night. People really trying to push the boat out, try to be a bit more spectacular. You could, at quarterfinal stage, get blamed for going a bit safe. Mm. And you know what it's like. You get that far and you don't want to suddenly throw something new in because everyone's a bit tired and you've done loads up to this point. So why not take some of your greatest hits and you just make each dance a greatest hits dance, really? Yeah. But they didn't. They were trying to new things. I mean, the Rose's leap and AJ's over the shoulder thing, and she had one way and then threw the arms the other way.
Yeah. They were amazing.
The John's sort of lift and release. I like that.
Let's talk about them a little bit more because I want to go through all the couples that are going to be in the semifinal this weekend. We're going to start with Reese and Nancy. They had a show-stopping weekend with their Argentine tango. Do you think that they're going to find it hard to balance two dances this week? He's got so much energy. Surely he'll be okay.
Well, I think he'll be fine because he's come a long way and he's understanding now what it takes to dance each dance individually. One size does not fit all. And you've got to be able to, you know, with his jive, you've got to let it all go, but again, not too much because it all starts to get a bit loose. But his tango, his Argentine tango, had to be completely contained and really involved. You couldn't have suddenly a loss of the moment because otherwise the whole thing becomes, well, loose and it just doesn't become an Argentine tango. So you lose the moment entirely. So I think he's becoming much more experienced in this, and I think two dancers will be fine for him this weekend.
I think,
as you say, so much energy, and I think he'll be able to pull them both off wonderfully. And I'm really looking forward to seeing what he comes up with.
Me too. They're doing great, those two. And then let's talk about John and Johannes. So they have been amazing throughout the series. We've seen some amazing choreography from them.
Yeah.
But now they've got Couples Choice this weekend, which is going to be really interesting. Are you excited to watch it?
I'm really excited about this because, you know, this could be a defining dance for John.
Yes, I think so too.
This could be the moment we've all sort of been waiting for in John and Johannes' partnership. So I'm really excited what dance style they choose, what their the mood of the dance is going to be, and obviously how they perform it. And their other dance is going to be really interesting as well because what is that? I don't know what that is.
Jive. So they're doing the jive. Ah. They're doing the jive.
You see, this could be two really strong dances. What's really important with all the couples is that you know in yourself, when you get to the stage of two dances, what you're going to be stronger at as a couple. And so you shouldn't be blamed for sort of putting all your eggs into one basket because you've got to take the dance off into consideration. You've been there and I've been there.
Yes.
And we know that anything could happen in the semi-final. So you really want to have one absolute stonker of a dance and one that you'll give as much time as you can, put as much effort into it as you can.
Yeah, there's always one that's stronger than the other.
You're always banking on one. So you've always got a thought in the back of your mind about the dance-off, and this dance is my banker for the dance-off.
Yeah.
And you wouldn't be blamed for giving that a bit of thought.
No. Well, AJ and Kai, they were in the dance-off this weekend, which I know would have ruffled her feathers a little bit, going into the semi-finals now. Do you think she's going to be able to bounce back? Any advice?
I think she'll be fine. I mean, as I said at the time, there are so few couples left and they haven't been into a dance-off before. They were bottom of the leaderboard. So it's not a massive shock that they end up in a dance-off. They dance well in a dance-off. Take that as your motivation for next week and go on from there. But the key is to forget it. You've got to dance with a brick wall right here. You can't look behind. You've just got to keep going forward. And you've got to move forward and grasp the semi-final with both hands and give it your best shot and not worry about what's gone before.
Yeah, and Rose and Giovanni, you mentioned them earlier in our chat. They did the epic lift this weekend in their American Smooth. They had the beautiful moment in the Couple's Choice where it was completely silent. Do you think that they've got any more tricks up their sleeves now for the semi-final?
Well, you know, that's a very good point, actually. What are you going to add to all that? I think her quality is the thing that she's going to base her dances on, because she's got such lovely quality, certainly in the ballroom dances. She's exquisite. And her Latin dances have improved week after week. Mm. So I'm really looking forward to seeing their performance. The most consistent couple through the whole competition, I think, has been John and Johannes, followed very closely by Rose and Giovanni. So it's going to be an epic week.
I think it is going to be an epic weekend. And you know what I can't wait for, Anton? I cannot wait to see you in the semi-final and listen to your brilliant one-liners, my old sausage. Anton Du Beke, everybody. We love him. Oh, I love him so much.